coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? What's up, guys? My name's Ram.
I'm Naija.
And this is Life with Ram and I.
We're gonna do a seafood boil, mukbang, whatever.
But with a twist. People we know personally, family, friends, frenemies.
They ask us questions, so we're gonna answer them now.
While slapping the seafood boil. So, let's get into it. We got it on. All right.
So. Ooh. I got shrimp, corn, potatoes. What is it? Oh, snow crabs.
I got mussels, snow crab, corn, potatoes. Mussels be slapping. And she also wants some of my mussels. So I'm just gonna give it to you from now. So in the middle of the video, I started eating my food. I don't know why I eat no. All right. When did we meet? You know what, 3 years back?
It was 2019.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, in school.
He was coming from the gym, and I was coming from getting food, and he happened to see me, asked me to hold the door, and I did.
Mm-hmm. Then, I'm like, shit, let me go for it. I asked her for a snap, and then we started texting from there. Yeah. Why you choose him or her to be the one?
Say.
Why did you choose him or her to be the one?
I chose you to be the one because you were different. You wasn't like what I was normally going for. Yeah. Mm. It was something different than what I was used to. So I tried to step out and give it a shot.
I know she was the one when she wasn't giving me city girl vibes, you know? She was calm, collected, soft-spoken at times, and not a lot of attitude and stuff. But also, she gave me like a peace vibes. Like I could come here and be at peace when I'm around. Well, you don't believe so?
Hmm?
You don't believe so?
You can get peace when you're with me. You get peace?
Mm-hmm.
I don't want peace. I want problems always.
Okay.
What made her or him different and stand out from all the other guys or girls?
It was the way you carried yourself. The way you carried yourself, it wasn't, well, with me, it wasn't no, oh, let me slide. I'm trying to, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was more so, I mean, you tried it. You did.
I don't recall. I don't remember that.
You did try it. Talking about my lips and then wanting to come to my room to chill and all that stuff. You tried it.
I'm with everything. Like, I'm with it all. What you want to do? I'm a slut. What's up? Get me lit. I dare you.
But in person, it was, you carried yourself different.
Mm-hmm. Not disrespect, I'm just gonna say it's like. But what makes her stand out from all of this? As I said, soft-spoken and stuff, and just hanging around her. I could still be me, because I'm like a real energetic type of person. And my vibe can make people smile, you know, personally. But with her, it was kind of weird, because she had like the RB face. So it's just like the whole time. But when I broke that down, she was this underneath. Mm-hmm. But those are the basic questions. Now let's get deep into it. While we're getting deep into it, you know what I'm saying? What do you consider a red flag or red flags about yourself? Ah, go first.
About ourselves?
Mm-hmm.
No. Let's do others. About each other.
About yourself, then we could confirm or deny.
Red flags about me then.
Mm-hmm.
You want me to be honest?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I'll be having red flags.
Scorn is good.
I got red flags.
Mm-hmm. That's it?
I don't think it. What red flag I got?
The red flags about myself, I'd say.
Look, damn. He lied.
I'd say that I don't take things too personally anymore. And that kind of like made some stuff slide in my life. I think that if I was to take some stuff personally, you know, stuff would have been different in a way.
A red flag I got would be, I don't let stuff go. I have a hard time letting stuff go. Cause if you did something, you better stand on that. Cause when I see you, that's it.
And another red flag I say I got is I'm a little bit impatient, but too patient at the same time.
Stop the cap.
Mm-hmm.
Too patient?
Mm-hmm. I said what I said.
Too patient where? Very much impatient.
And somewhat patient. Mm-hmm.
That sounds good.
Next question.
What is your long-term goal for this relationship?
Long-term goal? We got to get that's that long-term goal.
We die together? Ah, that's a little bit. That's a little bit too drastic. You can't say we live together.
We do.
Not reside together, like live. We live life instead of just surviving together.
That's the long-term goal. You ain't going nowhere.
She stuck to.
Psych.
Like glue. Like white on rice.
Oh, whatever.
Like red on blood. Yeah.
What's the long-term goal for you?
Long-term goal is to rebuild black love for me personally, and two is to really show that you could grow with one person, no matter how different they may be, whether their personality or their place of origin. Yeah. It's just all about the effort that you'll put in to stay with this person. And as long as you guys talk.
You make my answer seem like a bitch. Damn.
That's right.
What's some more questions?
What is the most attractive aspect about each other? The juicy stuff. I'm talking about this.
The most attractive
aspect about each other.
And your smile. His smile is just something different. Hits different.
I'm not gonna smile. I'm not gonna smile. Most attractive aspect about her is her lips and her skin tone.
Oh my God.
You don't get it. You fire, yo. It's just when the sun hits, like right now, death. But yeah, the most attractive aspect about her, I'd say it's that. There's more though, but at the moment, this is what I can think of. What is your love language?
I don't expect it, but gifts, I like gifts. I like to be surprised with gifts. And I mean, it's the same thing. It's the same thing, yeah. Gifts and quality time.
Well, my love language is acts of affirmation and also physical touch. Oh, I love me some physical touch. Like, yes, get on me. I like that itch, man. I need that. But yeah, physical touch and words of affirmation. Just that when you're really there for somebody mentally and physically and stuff, and they're like standoffish and stuff, you know that they're all about you. But it'll feel nice just to get a, you know, like, I hate it. Your feet look good. Well, not that, but, you know, just words of affirmation saying like they still love you and still like you and all of that. And physical touch. Like, do all of that while rubbing my scalp.
Yeah, I do that.
Massaging my beard.
I do that.
Oh yeah. This is intermediate. Let's get into the advanced questions. What's your body count? Alright. Too spicy. Too spicy.
No, I said it.
You could?
I said five.
Alright. Mine. I don't remember. But it's less than my age. That's not my age. Hey, it's better than people my age in college with an attractive status like mine.
So why I gotta say my number, but you can't say your number? Say your number.
My number is deep on my phone. I think it's like
21 probably.
Yeah, 21 or so. I'm not proud of it. Don't look at me like that. Have you ever thought about a threesome?
He needs some milk.
Answer question.
Haven't thought about it. Not really, but I had Yeah, I had.
Oh no! Don't answer this damn question, Mama.
Oh, answer that.
Answer what?
Have you ever thought about a little weed on be funny or a disgrace?
I have. I brought it up to him and everything. But it's just the thought of sharing. I can't do it.
Yeah, and I can't do that. Like, just to see, I met that man.
That's not another man. That's a train.
Or another woman.
I mean, man.
No, we're crapping this question out.
Nah, we can eat this one.
This thing's slapping.
I'm about to be done though.
Mm-hmm. Alright, we have a few more questions. Then we're gonna call it. Have you ever searched each other's phone?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Did I like what I find? No.
Explain.
No.
No. Yeah, I do. Do. Sometimes.
Stop the cap.
Yes, sometimes. I didn't find anything crazy. Sometimes just be finding new people added and stuff, but I don't think too deep.
And you vice versa.
Mm-hmm, but I don't think too deep into it. Do we have any insecurities about the other person leaving us?
No.
I'm not insecure about it, but am I terrified? Yes. It's scary. Because you know how much time and effort you put into this person just for them to leave. And then now they have your knowledge and knowledge that they learned through this experience just to go swinging on somebody else. Bullshit. But yeah, starting over, isn't it?
I wouldn't know.
So, am I insecure? No, but terrified? Yeah. What's a deal breaker for you in a relationship?
To be cheated on. Mm-hmm. That's a deal breaker.
Yeah. Yeah, being cheated on. And also, not being heard, as in you ask for something, as in relationship wise, not literally asking her to like pass the word or something, like relationship wise, and they just ignore your simple demand over and over and over again.
How do you feel about open relationships?
That's the one where one person could talk to the other person. Well, talk to somebody outside the other. But
both of y'all could too.
Open relationship, my ass. I'm just not a fan of it.
Mm-mm.
It's basically a threesome without the action.
I don't like sharing.
Well guys, it's the end of the video. Hope you guys liked it for our first video.
Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And let us know what else you want us to do.
Turn on post notification.
Mm-hmm.
And we will have more videos like this and others coming your way. Wake up, I'm my shorts. No, let me finish, please.
Why?
Let me finish my food.
Why?
I don't tickle you when you're eating.